This video clip is about a new add-on for ADS 2014-01 called DDR4 Compliance Test Bench. We created this product to solve the problem illustrated here. Your design, be it a DDR4 controller or a DDR4 system or your PCB or a DRAM memory chip itself, begins in the virtual world of EDA schematic capture, layout, and simulation. Your EDA company might provide a script that generates a compliance report. And let's say it passes, and on the strength of that, you invest the time and money to build a prototype. Then you get the prototype back from the fab and set it up in your lab as part of an end-to-end test bench. Now you capture the waveforms, maybe DQ, DQS bursts, with your oscilloscope, and your oscilloscope vendor might provide an app that generates a compliance report. But now the report says fail. What happened? Is my physical prototype somehow different from my virtual simulation? Or is the EDA company's compliance test somehow different from the scope vendor's app? How do I correlate the two and get to the bottom of this mess? Our solution leverages Keysight EEsof EDA's unique position as being part of Keysight Technologies, which is the world's leading electronic measurement company. DDR4 Compliance Test Bench consists of two parts, an end-to-end DDR4 simulation that you can easily customize with the IP block you want to test, and a script we call Waveform Bridge that writes out the simulated electrical and timing waveform in a format that our oscilloscope app uses for offline or stored data. If the simulation passes, you can fabricate with confidence because now when you get the prototype back from fab and plug it into the physical test bench for measurement, you can use the exact same app to determine electrical and timing compliance. No ifs, ands, or buts. In the rare case when there is a discrepancy, it has to be between the simulation and the physical world because the app is identical in both cases, so now you know where to look. Let's take a closer look at how this works. We begin with the simulated test bench, which is modular and hierarchical, so you can easily customize it by swapping out generic blocks for your IP blocks as needed. You can use netlist models, traditional IBIS models, S-parameter models from an EM simulator, or whatever, anything that runs under transient simulation. After running the simulation, the Waveform Bridge script writes the waveforms into an HDF5 format in a schema that your Keysight Infinium software understands. You don't need to tie up the embedded PC in the scope. You can read in the waveforms in Infinium Offline, which runs on a regular Windows PC. We call this mode Offline, meaning stored data, and Remote, meaning off the scope and on a remote PC. Simply select the files that Waveform Bridge wrote out for you and select the tests you want to run. These aren't oscilloscope waveforms. They are a sequence of voltage-time pairs generated by ADS simulations. The app applies Keysight measurement science and our unique understanding of the DDR spec to ensure compliance. Keysight staff serve on the JEDEC board of directors and are intimately involved not just in understanding the spec, but actually writing it. Now let's take a look at the test bench and I'll demonstrate the following. Setting up a DDR4 data bus simulation in Agilent's advanced design system, generating data signal and strobe signal waveforms, and running DDR4 electrical and timing compliance tests with Agilent's DDR4 compliance software. What you see here is a top-level simulation setup for a DDR4 data bus in write operation. That is, the memory controller on the left is transmitting data to the DRAM on the right. The block on the left is a pattern generator, generating data and strobe burst waveforms. Moving to its right are the controller driver models for the single-ended data bus pins and differential strobe pins. The data and strobe signals out of the controller drivers will go through packages and PCB traces, which are represented by an S-parameter file from an electromagnetic simulation. The signals out of the DRAM package pins become the input signals to the DRAM data receiver. At the end of the simulation, the data, strobe, and clock signals at the DRAM receiver pins will be saved for electrical and timing compliance analysis. After I press the simulate button and wait for the simulation to finish, I get a set of waveforms. The waveforms are shown in this folder. The waveforms are written in a binary format called HDF5, or in short, H5. I can open these waveforms in Agilent's Infinium Offline software for viewing and analysis, as shown here. At this point, I'll invoke the DDR4 compliance test engine to run a set of compliance tests on these simulated waveforms that I just generated. Here is the DDR4 compliance app. I'll first select the speed grade, which is 2400 megatransfers per second. I'll then click on Offline Setup to load the waveforms generated by my simulation. Next, I select a subset of the compliance tests to run. Since my simulated waveforms are from a WRITE operation, I'll select the WRITE cycle tests only, here and here. I'll click on the Connect tab next. Since I'm running the offline version of the compliance test software, no hardware connection is necessary. I can simply run the tests on the simulated waveforms. At the end of the tests, I'll get an HTML report telling me which tests passed and which tests failed. Finally, here's a typical product configuration you'll need to do simulation compliance. Obviously, to do physical compliance in your lab, you'll also need a Keysight Infinium oscilloscope, not listed here. For more information about Keysight EEsof EDA's simulation solutions for DDR4 and other signal integrity applications, or to download a free trial, please visit us at this website.